a normal day. Where I'm standing right now used to be a very, very busy area. In fact, there is always used to be a traffic jam here because this is Oshoji, one of the busiest business center in Lagos State. But today, as you can see, the roads are empty. Young men playing football on the road. If there is anything at all, the Nigerian Labour Congress must have scored a vital point in the day one of the strike.
It was the first strike that will record 100% compliance by Nigerians who are known to ignore strikes for their business concerns. But this time, even the ever-busy Oshodi was simply the shadow of itself.
This is the only one. And this only one we are getting, we are not getting the something like free medicals and other things, which has been happening in Libya. In Libya, Gaddafi was doing all these things, and the people still didn't want him. In Nigeria here, this is the only benefit we are getting from government, which is subsidizing fuel alone.
What we are talking about is impromptu. She should give us time, do you understand? And you do it gradually, not that you just, you enforce it on people.
The Apapa Oshodi Expressway looks like a field track where cars are free to run at any speed they like, since neither the heavy trucks nor trailers, who are kings of the road, can be seen this Monday. An indication of a total compliance with the strike. At Ejigbo, different youth groups carried placards chanting songs to express their displeasure with the sudden increase in fuel price. The situation became more tense on getting to Igbejimu and Ikotun axis of the state.
As the free tire not press on us, from 65 naira to 150, it's not accepted to Nigerian masses.
Egbeda and Iyanokpaja was relieved of the daily traffic gridlock as people take to the highway to play football and relax. But the calamity was later to set in as the peaceful rally was punctured at Agege Ogba axis. Our crew ran into protesting youths carrying a lifeless body on the wheelbarrow to police station. At Penn Cinema police station, armed policemen were battle ready for the youth who have come to deposit the corpse of the young man allegedly shot by a senior police officer.
Well, it was a terrible situation by 9 o'clock this morning. People are in a peaceful demonstration at the Ayaba Convention. So, some policemen just came from Penn Cinema. When they come, the first release won't go to up. And it was later, they fire, straight bullet. They killed one people and injured three people.
When you are saying they are more aggrieved, it depends on the way it touches them. You know, the level of those that are living in Agege are just middle class. So most of them are not so much in the one that we can say. They really know how the market, the oil subsidy really affects them.
At the county hospital were three others who are receiving treatment from bullet wounds. One of the survivors explained what happened.
I was coming from the boat of here. I went to read sports people. So on my way coming at the junction, at the Abata junction there, and I saw those policemen, they were just shooting. And I wanted to cross, as I was about to cross, the bullet just got my leg.
The youths are demanding justice for their slain colleague as the protest gradually shifted to a battle between police and youth of the area. Tunji Olanipekun, Television Continental News.